I'm going to have to eat my words a little bit this week, because a few videos back I was discussing the differences between Blazor Server and Blazor WebAssembly, and I was pretty much down on Blazor Server, wasn't too keen on it because it seemed to me it's going to have drawbacks because of the way it works in terms of the large number of round trips between the client and the server for virtually every interaction, and also that the server has to remember data about every client, and so as you get more clients, it scales very badly on the server side. But there is one variation of that Blazor Server idea that actually works very, very well. And that is a feature of .NET that's still in preview, which is a thing called MAUI Blazor. Now, MAUI is Microsoft's new way of getting desktop applications to work across multiple platforms. So not just Windows, but also iOS and Linux and things like that. It stands for Multi-Platform App UI. That's where MAUI comes from. And I thought I'd go a bit into the history of all this, because back in the 90s, when I was working in C++, we had similar issues of how you can write one set of software and get it to run on multiple platforms. And the way a language like C++ addresses that is essentially that C++ is a standardized language, so you can write one set of source code, and then you have different compilers for different platforms that turn that standard source code into the machine code for the particular platform. That has some problems. You've got to have lots and lots of different compilers. And so an alternative way of doing that that is used in .NET and in Java and some other environments is to have a runtime environment. So when you build a C# application, that compiles down to a thing called Common Intermediate Language, and then that Common Intermediate Language will run on a runtime environment on whatever platform that you have, which will then dynamically turn it into the machine code that's necessary. But in both of those approaches, the actual code that runs on the processor is not really the trickiest thing, it turns out. The really hard thing to do is to get any kind of desktop GUI going, because desktop GUIs are very, very different from different platforms, one to another, where you have Windows, or you have X Windows, or you have iOS, or all sorts of different things like that. And so, again, going back to C++, the way that was done with was with a third-party library, so Qt was one that I use that's still around today, that would basically give you a programming interface onto a GUI that you would program in a standardized way, but then would be implemented differently on the different platforms. And it tended to be a bit clunky. It could work, but you were kind of limited to what the particular third-party library provided for you, and you often missed off nice features on a particular platform with its GUI. And so traditionally with C# and .NET, that has been a problem. Getting it to run as a console app or something like that on different platforms has always been available and was made a lot easier once Core was introduced. And therefore you could run a console app or you could use a console app as a web server, but getting the GUI running cross-platform hadn't really worked. And actually, to some extent, the problem was worked around by the fact that one standardized way we do have of having GUIs is the browser. So we've got browsers that run standard HTML, we've got multiple different browsers, they run on different operating systems, but they work in the same sort of way, and therefore we've got a consistent programming interface to do GUIs, not desktop GUIs, browser GUIs, but still that's pretty good, and we can do that on a multiplicity of platforms. And in fact, one way that this has been used is to have what is known as a progressive web app, which is basically a web application, but one which, rather than running in a generalized browser, uses the browser engine to run as if it were a dedicated program. And we can do this in really any web technology, so you could do it in Angular or React or plain old JavaScript, or indeed you could do it in Blazor WebAssembly. And in fact, I can show you that pretty easily. If we go for a new Blazor WebAssembly app here, and let's call this PWA demo, so progressive web application. Click next on that, and you can see amongst the options we get, we've got this progressive web application. And if I create that, then it's just given us the standard out-of-the-box Blazor application. So we have our pages for the counter and that sort of thing. But what it's also put in there is essentially a couple of things. And you could have done this by hand, but it's easier just to get it generated. It's given us this manifest.json, and that basically describes to the browser that this is running on the details of how it can be installed as one of these PWAs. And so the icons it's going to use when it's installed, that sort of thing. And then also it adds this service worker.js, which hasn't got very much code there. But one of the ideas of progressive web applications is they should run as well as they possibly can, even when there's no connectivity to the server. And so what you put in the service worker is a lot of code for downloading and caching any information that you might need when you're not running. But if we run that up and drag it over, we'll see it's just the perfectly normal out-of-the-box Blazor app that you'd expect. But what it's given us is this extra little button. That's what it does in Chrome. Similar things on different browsers, on whatever platform you like, so particularly important on mobile devices and that sort of thing. But it's giving us the option to install this PWA demo. So now if I run that and install it, and then you'll see it's now, if I drag that over, given me exactly the same thing, but running in its own window. And indeed, if I close that down and just go to the Windows button, we can see PWA demo as recently installed. I can run that up and it runs up again, exactly the same program, but running in what looks like its own window. It's still really just the browser engine, but it looks more like an application, and that could run on any platform because it's just using the browser. That's all it's got to have. So that's quite a neat way of getting a step towards this idea of having a desktop application that can run absolutely anywhere with only one set of source code, one build that we have to have for it. But there is a slight limitation on that, because although this one we're actually doing using Blazor WebAssembly, therefore we've got our C# running on the client, it's still running inside the browser and therefore in the sandbox that the browser provides for safety. And what that means is that we're not able to fully exploit the operating system like we would with an actual installed application. So, for example, we're not going to be able to do any particularly good multi-threading. We're not going to be able to access the file system and read and write files, which could be very important. And so other issues like that we're not going to be able to have. And so although PWAs are pretty good, that's a limitation of them. But then the next step is where we get back to the idea of Blazor server. Because remember the issues I said about having the server, which means you have a round trip for any communication, for any interaction between the client and the server, and also if the server has multiple clients, it slows down. But what if we put both the server and the client on the same machine? That then gets rid of all those disadvantages, because round trips are trivial, you're on the same machine, and you're not going to have multiple clients because you've got the server and the client on the same machine, a one-to-one relationship. And that essentially is what we have with MAUI Blazor. So we actually have both the server and the client running on the same machine. It gives you the cross-platform capability because you're just using HTML, CSS at the front end, and gives you fully featured C# because your server is running as an installed application. So let's have a look and see how we can do that. Now, to do this, at the moment, we actually have to go to the preview version of Visual Studio 2022 version 17.3. So it's not yet available in the main version. So that's what we've got here. But what I'll do is create a new project. And you can see I've already selected MAUI in that drop down there. And we've got three options. We've got a class library for general reuse. And then we've got both the standard MAUI and the MAUI Blazor. So the standard MAUI, you basically use XAML like you would for WPF, the extensible application markup language, whereas in the Blazor one, you can use HTML. So that's what we're going to go for. So if I click on that, create the new one, just call this MAUI Blazor demo and create that. And you can see we've got this MAUI Blazor demo. If we look at the pages, we'll see that it's the same things we get for all our Blazor apps as a template. You'll also notice if we take a look here at the run options, we can see as well as the Windows machine, which will just run it locally where we are now, we've got various emulators available. So I've got Android emulators, iOS emulators, and so we could run this up in any one of those platforms to see how it was actually working on that target platform. But we'll just run it up in Windows Machine for now. And drag it over. We can see doesn't look very different from the progressive web app. We've got the application running in its own window. But the difference is the actual C# part of that is running as an app on the underlying platform rather than running within the browser in a sandbox way. If we just look a bit at the structure of all this, the thing that's most important is you'll notice we do have a XAML page. So we've got this main page.xaml, we've got the app.xaml as well, but the main page.xaml. And in there, we have this Blazor web view, which then launches index.html, and that's what gets us into the realms of a Blazor application, just as we're familiar with. So it is still using XAML, but only really to bootstrap in to give us this window where we can then put our Blazor. And actually, you could mix the two together if you wanted to. So you could have some XAML and some Blazor in there if you'd got different resources come from different places. The benefit of doing it using Blazor is really simply one of what your skills base is and what your code base is. So if you've already got lots of components written for Blazor, you can very quickly get them running in MAUI just by putting them in this way. Or if, like me, you've got pretty good HTML skills and not very good XAML skills, I'd feel much more comfortable doing this sort of thing in HTML and CSS than in XAML. So that's something that I can do without having to do lots of retraining into XAML. So you can do it either way, but those are the arguments as to why you might have one way or the other. Now, just to show you this last idea, to show you something that you could not do with Blazor or with any other web app, even a progressive web app, let's try accessing the file system. So something I've created earlier is over here under users JASP, I've got this for maui.txt, which is just a text file containing a message. This is on the file system. So that's just something that we're going to interact with. And then let's go to one of our pages. Let's go to the counter page. So at the moment, when we click the button, that's going to just increment the count. But now let's get it to do something a bit different. So what I will put on here is a private string message, which I'll initialize to original message. And then we'll put in that current count, let's simply put at message. And then let's just put load on there. Leave the name the same, though I should change it because I'm not incrementing the count anymore. And then what I'm going to do is in here, I'm going to say stream reader equals new stream reader. And then I'm going to open it up at that C users JASP for maui.txt. And then I'm going to say message equals reader dot read line. And so that should do everything I want. And so if I run that up now, drag it over, go to the counter. There we've got the original message. I click load, and there we've interacted with the file system. So very, very simple, but certainly something you could not do in a web application, even a progressive web application, because we're interacting with the filing system. So that was it. Just a quick look at what we've got with MAUI, and particularly with MAUI using Blazor, which for me is the one I would prefer to use because I'm more familiar with HTML than I am with XAML. But they're both available. They're still in preview, as I said, but we'll see how they progress and how they manage to make this idea of cross-platform development really easy and accessible to .NET developers. So hope you enjoyed that. If you did, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.